Fargo, North Dakota is experiencing historic flooding, and U.S. Geological Survey scientists continue to monitor the stream flow as the floodwaters rise.
We've been out measuring how much discharge is passing the town of Fargo. We've been doing this daily. Yesterday we measured 25,900 CFS. CFS is a cubic foot per second, about the size of a basketball. And we had 25,900 basketballs passing Fargo every second. Today we measured 28,700 basketballs passing Fargo per second, and the stage is still rising. After the completion of the measurement yesterday, actually, I immediately went on a conference call with the Army Corps of Engineers, the National Weather Service, and my supervisors with the USGS, and they made some decisions regarding the elevation of the levees. Since yesterday, they've actually raised the levee in the area of our gauging structure by about 3 feet. A lot of this was done based on the discharge numbers we measured yesterday.
Well, we had a little bit of difficulty this morning. Our previous boat ramp, which was a bike path before, was sandbagged, so we couldn't get our boat in there. So we had to take our boat to the other side of the river where there are submerged roads, and there was about 100 feet of ice we had to break through with our boat. We had to go in by hand and break out a channel and then take the boat through the ice to get out to the water. So we were a little concerned about if that was going to work or not. We have a jet boat, and getting ice into the intake was an issue, but it worked out fine, and we had a lot of safety measures in place, like a rope attached to it until they knew our engine was working and it was clear. We had the Coast Guard calling every 15 minutes, so we took as many precautions as we could, and it all worked out.
The measurement we provided today to the National Weather Service will be used to recalculate the peak forecast, and it may impact whether the town of Fargo needs to be evacuated or not. It makes me realize how important the numbers we provide are.
CoreCast is a product of the U.S. Geological Survey, Department of the Interior.